practicing over here. Gotta thank our boy over there at Guitar Meets Science for helping me work out that guitar solo I was asking about. He's got it down. I've been practicing and everything. So y'all just hang on, because we're gonna be breaking the law pretty damn soon over here at Rocker Pat's. All right, guys, let's see what I got going on. Today I've been playing my KK guitar. That's my little dinky Jackson. And when I wanna play Glenn, I get out the black guitar, my Ibanez, and play Glenn Tipton. KK Downing, Glenn Tipton. Why? Because KK plays a red guitar, and Glenn plays a black one. So there we go. All right, there's the other Jackson, for those who need to see the Jacksons, and the Epi. All right, so let's see what I got going on. All right, guys, I'm sorry I have not done an update on the 1954 Bel Air two-door hardtop. Truth is, I haven't really done a lot with it. Been working on the house, going up there to leg it. Being that it's cool outside, it's, you know, if I'm gonna have to be wearing pants and heavy boots and stuff like that to cut trees down and all that kind of stuff, I'd rather do that during the winter time, because it gets hot as a son of a bitch here in Houston. Hell, man, today's January the 18th, day after my birthday, and ain't nobody loves me, ain't nobody even take me out to dinner or anything, nothing. So anyway, it's supposed to have been a cool front today, but I'm wearing short sleeve shirts and could be in shorts. So anyway, let's see what I got going on. I believe it was last week sometime, I didn't have any work, and I got my lazy ass out there, because that's part of the problem right there too. And I welded in the driver's side floor pans, front and rear. They're completely welded in. I got one little spot right here that I need to patch, and one spot right there. That's a pretty simple little gig. But I ran out of flap disc and grinding disc. I've got some on order. Got some roll locks came in, but I haven't got any flap disc for my 4.5-inch angle grinder to grind them welds down a little bit. But then, you know, they don't need to be all that great. Today, again, got off my lazy ass, and basically all I've got done is I started fitting in a driver's floor pan. I've got it set pretty good where I want it. It's clecoed in properly and you know, tied up against the brace that's up underneath here. Floor brace that bolts to the frame. Just like you see right there in that hole, one of them bolts right there will go in that hole, going through the frame, and then that one's bolted to the frame as well with a rubber frame mount, body mount, bushing, or whatever you want to call it. So anyway, like I said, I got it shaped the way I want it. Got my step in it right here. I used my bead roller to roll that in. All I got left to do to this, truthfully, is I got a little bit of massaging to do down this rail right here to get it fit and flat up against what I left up underneath there. And I need to go ahead and roll those 6 beads in it so that it gives it structure and strength. But yeah, that came out pretty good. I'm pleased I got that done today. Starting to look like a car again and everything. Everybody else is getting their cars done and I'm kind of being lazy about it and everything, you know. It is what it is. I'll get there. Don't worry. It'll happen. It's just one day at a time and everything. But yeah, man, that's what we're doing over here. Tomorrow I am going to, tomorrow I'm going back up to my property. I've been fighting these two chainsaws. Hang on, let me turn a light on here. We got the stage lighting going. Been fighting these two chainsaws. This one, I mean, I don't know how many of you guys know anything about chainsaws, but this one here, man, it just cut crazy. And what I figured out was it had a 50 gauge chain on it and a 58 gauge bar. And that was just kicking the chain sideways and it wouldn't cut worth the crap. This little steel I got here, it cut good, but man, I just couldn't keep the chain sharp. So now I decided that I ain't leaving without some potato salad. And in this case, the potato salad is 2 more chains for that one. And they only had 1 chain for this one, so I could only buy 1. The next time I go to where I buy them, I'll see if they got another one. But I don't want to go 100 miles and not be able to cut down what I have, a tree half cut down, and I can't get it to cut the rest of the way because it won't, the chains are dull and it won't, you know, cut anymore. But one thing I did do is I stopped off at the local, you know, $39.99 Harbor Freight. Well, I think that was $29. And I like that a whole lot better than trying to file it by hand, because I've just come to the conclusion that I ain't that good at filing it by hand, damn it, because my chain kept going dull all the time, quick. So I'm gonna give this a try. We're going back up there. May or may not make a video on the house tomorrow. There's really not much going on. I'm going up there to do two things, well, really three. I got some trees that I need to keep cutting. I'm gonna go to that gable end and I'm gonna do some precise measuring and start ordering some lumber for that so that we can get that fixed. And three, the last time I was up there, I started gutting out the bathroom and got all the fixtures and everything out of the way so I can start looking at seeing what I gotta do with the floor. But anyway, it's flooring it over here, and I'll be flooring it tomorrow, and we'll floor it the next day and keep flooring it until we get it floored. All right, guys, well, y'all keep rocking and a rolling and a rolling and a rocking, and everybody say hello to Petey Doggy. And I'm gonna get my ass back to rocking and a rolling and a rolling and a rocking. And y'all keep grinding it down. Talk to y'all next time.